Basketball on 2K Sports Fans. Hi, this is Kevin Harlan alongside Steve Kerr, Clark Kellogg, and Doris Burke. A quick check now at the starting five for both teams. One of the guys we'll be watching out for today, Zach Randall.
When you bring his name up, what I can't get out of my head is how ferocious he is as a rebounder.
You know, that's really a good way to describe him. He devotes so much energy to his work on the boards, it makes him hard to handle.
Take a look at the Grizzlies. Well, compared to last season, you'd have to say the start to this season has not been quite what you'd expect. They hope to improve their record with the win tonight, certainly.
You know, right now for the Grizzlies, you know, they've had a very tough time getting anything going so far. I mean, this was not the kind of start they imagined for themselves.
No, I'm sure it wasn't. I mean, they had high hopes coming into this season, and yet everything seems to have gone wrong for them.
Conley with it. Matthews covering. Allen. Kept alive. Looking at Portland, they want to turn it around after the loss to the Suns and Phoenix.
And I think the sort of issues they had on defense, in part at least, was a bigger factor. Really compounded, I think, because it was on the road. You have to be sharper when you go out and play as a visitor.
Yeah, everything has to be tight. You can't be loose in any aspect of your game. You're fighting against the crowd and the opponent. You've got to be tougher, mentally and physically, if you're going to win on the road. And, you know, a great start for last season's Rookie of the Year, Damian Lillard. Assuming the mantle of starting point guard for the Blazers and proving himself more than ready for the task. He played with a poise and maturity that you rarely see in young point guards in the NBA.
Now, here's Batum. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against Phoenix.
Yeah, he picked his spots in that game, too, Kevin, because I thought he not only did a nice job scoring, but setting up his teammates as well.
Three misses to start the game, still trying to break the seal on that hoop.
Matthews gets the screen from Lopez. There's the feed to Lillard. And the layup is good after a nice lead pass. And for Lillard, he came a long way from being a lightly recruited player out of high school and being a star at a small school, Weber State, to the number 6 pick in the 2012 draft and a day one starter for the Blazers.
But you know, Kevin, he doesn't seem like the guy who's going to be satisfied with just winning Rookie of the Year. He's got more in store. He's got more on his mind, becoming an all-star, becoming a winner, and it's going to be important for him to continue to work on his game and develop.
Well, when we were riding over tonight in the car to the arena, you were saying I love his demeanor.
Yeah, and his work ethic, and just the way he carries himself.
Now here is Conley. He's coming off a 16-point game against Brooklyn.
And don't forget, guys, his playmaking was sensational. I mean, he saw the floor, making the game so easy for his teammates.
Excellent execution of the plan there.
Well, it was the Memphis Grizzlies in their last game, a loss to the Brooklyn Nets.
You know, they didn't exactly roll over. They had a good chance to win in that game. Just didn't come together for them at the right time.
Hey, the all-around effort was very solid, but they're not interested in moral victories. A loss is a loss.
It's Allen with the drive. Gasol inside, Lopez covering, and he buries that one, drilling the rim on the way down. And a little over 2.5 minutes gone here in the first. Here's Lillard, and he gets it to go. Lillard's got his second basket.
And the layup just gift-wrapped right there. I mean, he had a clear path to the basket.
Conley, the pass to Allen. Allen, right side. Back to Conley. 6 to shoot. Inside to Randall. And stolen by Aldridge. Batum attacking. Matthews with it. Guarded now by Prince.
Guys, it's no surprise that a young team like the Blazers found it difficult sledding on the road. Not quite the experience or edge needed to put together good performances on a nightly basis away from home.
Catching up on the changes for Portland. Myers Leonard, he's checked in for Lopez. Thomas Robinson comes in for LaMarcus Aldridge. And Mo Williams subbed in for Damian Lillard. Now here is Conley, averaging 18 points a game. Well, for the Blazers, statistically, they played as close as you could ask for as to when they played at home, but they didn't really have the roster to protect the rim and Steve forced turnovers, which is always a big help on the road.
Yeah, their interior defense was a problem last year. A lot of teams just ate them up, particularly when Portland would go out on the road. That's one of the reasons they finished 11-30. You have to be able to defend at a high level to win away from home.
Now Bayless. Mo Williams missing from long range. Six on the shot clock. Here's Prince. Again, Memphis. And 101 left to play in the first quarter. Williams against Conley. Portland, no good that time either.
Great defense there. You really have to challenge him at that range.
Clark, this offense has really been clicking.
No doubt about it, giving the defense all kinds of trouble.
And they're playing with so much energy offensively. The ball is really moving.
Now here is Davis. He's coming off a 10-point game against Brooklyn.
I thought his rebounding was impressive as well. Guys, he made some big boards, really helped out on the glass, helped his team out big time.
Here's Williams after Ed Davis's score. Dishes to Leonard. Portland, no good that time either. Here's Pondexter, defended by Batum. And here comes Williams, looking for his first basket still in this one. Misses in close.
There was just enough defensive pressure to get him off balance and cause that shot to go awry.
And so the first quarter is in the books. Grizzlies lead by 5. Now the second quarter getting ready to start up. And taking a look at the Grizzlies' performance here, guys, what have they been doing or not doing?
And I thought the defense was key here for this club. They really tightened up and made it difficult on their opponent.
How about the help on the drives and rotations? I mean, they've really been in sync as a unit.
Trailblazers trail by 5. And a chance here presented by Gatorade to see who's on the floor, all fueled up and ready to go for the start of the second quarter. So on the floor for Memphis. We've got Zach Randolph. Jared Bayless is out there with Allen. Then there's Quincy Pondexter, and it's Davis in at the 4 spot.
You know, a big part of the success of LaMarcus Aldridge is his versatility. He can play power forward. You can slide him over and move him to the center spot. But you know, he's very difficult for anybody to handle. Almost 7 feet tall and extremely skilled. Looked like there was a little confusion there as to who was supposed to be guarding him.
Here's the Trailblazers with the ball. 6-point game. Well, they've got the Lakers ahead of them after this game. In their next game, it'll be played in Los Angeles. That'll be the 3rd game of this 3-game road trip.
Man, you know the fans out in L.A. really hoping for a win in that one.
That's good. Well, going back to Aldridge for a second, he really does have the skill set of a power forward, Clark, and the body of a center.
Yeah, you know, that versatility is really impressive. When you think about a big guy guarding him, he can take him outside and utilize that jumper and quickness. And then if he has a smaller guy, he'll back him down and work him over inside.
Let's go to our sideline reporter, Doris Burke. Doris, what do you have?
Well, gentlemen, you recall around draft night, there were rumors that the Cavaliers were willing to trade both the number 1 and number 19 picks for LaMarcus Aldridge, but they were rebuffed by Portland. And it's easy to see why the Blazers would be reluctant to part with their franchise big man. But with Aldridge expressing unhappiness in Portland over the summer, you wonder if that's a decision they'll live to regret. Kevin?
No question, Doris. Everyone's got to be invested and on board, or it just doesn't work. Randall, and a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot 2 right here.
Well, you look at Zach Randolph, and he doesn't have the typical body of a dominant power forward. But regardless of what his body looks like, you can't deny how hard he works on his game and conditioning during the season and during the offseason. You know, he's a hard worker, and that's part of why Memphis has really embraced him. They love Zach Randolph and what he represents because they can relate to that grinded-out mentality he has.
Robin Lopez has checked in for Portland. And Randolph drops them both. Oh, Clark, you mentioned Randolph's condition. Last season, he changed his pregame routine, started lifting weights before every game.
Said it gave him a little more bounce in his stride, and something was working. He led the league in offensive boards last season. After digging themselves that hole in the first quarter, this club is starting to shoot the ball much better now.
Yeah, you know, sometimes it takes a little while to work out the knots. I mean, they're starting to put it together.
He dishes it to Bayless. Marcus Aldridge grabs the miss. Aldridge has got three rebounds now in this one. Williams kicks to right. Lillard outside. And Allen with the block. They get it back. Good! Now just a one-point Grizzly lead.
He's making it look easy scoring out there because he's much more efficient here in the second.
And Bayless kicks to Allen, trying his luck deep. Memphis the rebound. Passes it to Bayless. It's Allen on the wing. He's guarded by Williams. Bayless's shot is off. Trailblazers have gone 5 of 6 so far from the field in the second quarter.
Well, for the Grizzlies, the fifth best record in the league last season, guys. Defeated the Clippers and the Thunder in the playoffs, but it all came to a crashing in when the Spurs swept them in the conference finals.
Now here's Williams. After the miss from Pondexter, that gives them the lead. 6 points for Lillard.
Another lead change. How many of these are we going to have?
I don't know, Steve, but the momentum of this game has certainly swung like a pendulum.
Pondexter dishes to Randolph. The pass to Pondexter. Shoots from the right block. And Randolph with the basket on the assist by Pondexter. Randolph's got 6 here in this quarter. Well, and back in that series that Clark was talking about against the Spurs, more competitive than it might seem. Steve, you and I were talking about this. 3 of the 4 games were close. In fact, 2, obviously, really close, going to overtime.
But I thought the weakness of Memphis was really exposed, Kevin, and that was the outside shooting. San Antonio just guarded the paint. They took Zach Randolph pretty much out of the series, and they begged Memphis to shoot from long range. And when you don't have floor spacing in the playoffs, it makes it awfully tough to score.
Doris Burke has some information for us. Doris?
During that break, Coach Dave Yeager had some words for his team. He preached patient offense and using more of the shot clock. He'd like the tempo of this game to be taken down a few notches. He also doesn't want them to forget the importance of playing aggressive defense on the perimeter and contesting every outside shot. So, Kevin, change is already being made on the fly here in the second quarter.
Thanks, Doris. Here's Lillard, following the score by Tayshaun Prince. Lillard, the pass to Robinson, lays it up and in on the nice reverse. Robinson's got his first points of the game.
They've had assists now on their last 3 baskets.
And it's not just their passing, but their cutting, their movement together as a unit that's led to that.
It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. Gasol kicks to Allen. Back to Gasol. Shoots from the baseline. It's hauled in by the Trailblazers. This is, of course, their first opportunity to play Memphis this season.
And this is a big game, guys, today, because these teams will see each other 3 more times down the road, and this one kind of sets the tone for the season series.
The Trailblazers have been perfect at the line so far, albeit just 2 for 2. The Grizzlies making a switch here. And both free throws good for Lopez.
We're seeing today what makes him one of the best free throw shooters among the league's big men. Beautiful stroke.
And the first half ends in a close one. Trailblazers out in front. They lead by 3. Live from the FedEx Forum, you're watching 2K Sports.
And now, brought to you by Sprint.
And now get ready for the halftime report. We're happy to be part of your Sunday. A tight game for Portland, squaring off against Memphis. A strong beginning to the season. They've wasted no time in getting off on the right foot. A tremendous first half for LaMarcus Aldridge. He's picked up half a dozen points, and it's been a good overall defensive game for him. He's brought a nice intensity to the floor in this one. The Pelicans will face off against the Knicks in New York. There's going to be some excitement in the arena for that one. A 7:30 Eastern tip time. And another game that's coming up out in Sacramento, it'll be the Kings against the Warriors. Tim Duncan picked up the player of the week in the West.
The Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
The third quarter now beginning. Both sides looking to pull away in the last half of the game. Without question, Zach Randolph displaying his skills today.
He is a dynamic scorer, guys. That much we know. And I'll tell you what, his talent was on full display there in the first half.
Steve, he is a hard man to keep down. And so far, they've been unable to do it.
On the court right now for the Trailblazers. Filling out the wings, it's Matthews and Batum. Aldridge and Lopez are down low. And it's Lillard in a point guard.
And LaMarcus Aldridge, an all-star for the third straight season. You know, looking back, he's really been the jewel of that 2006 draft class where he went second overall.
Conley's shot is off.
That's not a sight you see very often. I mean, he has a great feel for that jump shot, especially when he's open.
Lillard dishes to Matthews. Back to Lillard. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two. Now Clark, you talk about Aldridge and what he's meant to the Trailblazers. Really the franchise player, Steve, in Portland. I think they look at him that way.
And for a team that had to rebuild on the fly after losing so many of their key players to injury, going back to Brandon Roy and Greg Oden, it's nice to see the Blazers bounce back and start to get Aldridge some help with guys like Damian Lillard and Batum and Matthews.
It's good, and he drew contact on the shot, so he will go to the line. A three-point play chance here.
For the majority of his career, Marc Gasol has been referred to as the other Gasol, but last season you can make that case that he surpassed his brother Powell in terms of impact on the court.
That free throw good from Gasol. Marc Gasol, a little bigger than his older brother Powell, very comfortable at the center position, whereas Powell is a little more of a tweener. They're both obviously so incredibly skilled.
They sure are. I mean, both Gasols able to play in the high post as passers or jump shooters or down on the low block, and where they can use their array of offensive skills. Pretty impressive to see two players like that coming out of the same family.
Now let's go to Doris Burke. Doris?
Kevin, there's no doubting Damian Lillard is off to a great start in his NBA career and is a great match with LaMarcus Aldridge in the pick and roll game. Aldridge, no doubt, happy to have such a ready-made teammate, saying, quote, "The thing that stands out the most is his pace and poise. He has all the tools to be great, and he listens and is trying to grow." Coach Stotts summed it up this way: "He's legit, gentlemen."
An intriguing young talent. Thanks.
It's the 10th straight point they've given up in the paint. I guess the good news is they've taken away the outside shot.
Well, you know what? It doesn't matter how good their perimeter defense is if they're going to allow inside looks as easy as that.
Here is Conley following the basket by LaMarcus Aldridge. Allen with it. Matthews covering. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Damian Lillard. That's his first foul.
Yeah, close, but I didn't think he got on balance quickly enough.
And it's hard to draw charges as quick as players are at this level. That's not an easy bit of work there.
Catching up on the changes for Portland. Leonard, he's checked in for Lopez. And Mo Williams subbed in for Damian Lillard.
Now, slight advantage for them in the rebound category. They've got to continue their work on the glass.
Yeah, I agree with you, Steve. I mean, they're on the right side of the ledger, and that is all that matters to them right now with the lead they have.
Williams passes to Aldridge. It's good. Great play by Williams to set it up. And now it's an 8-point Trailblazer lead.
I don't know what's happening to their defense. I mean, they don't have any effort, any purpose.
And it's really costing them. I mean, the last five baskets at that end have been on very easy looks.
He was all alone on that one. Bayless has got 6 points.
You might not think of him as a laser three-point shooter, but that shot was there for him, and he had to take it. You know, guys, Portland had one of the worst benches in the history of the league last season. You know, they didn't get much contribution there. It was almost like they went into every game playing 5 versus 12.
Here's Prince, and another basket for Memphis.
Good ball move. He put that pass in the ideal spot, right where it needed to be.
Trailblazers leading by three. Now a timeout called by Portland. Well, as Clark was talking about when referring to the Blazers, the bench scoring was a big problem for him, as they didn't have anyone really outside the start. On for 7 points or more a game.
Yeah, look, the NBA game is 48 minutes long. It's tough to survive for those full four quarters when you have no offensive punch off the bench. But I think this offseason they added a lot of firepower, a lot of scoring in reserve, and we'll see if that makes a difference for this team this year.
And let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
During that break, Coach Dave Yeager had some words for his team. He was making sure everyone knew exactly what the plan was guarding against Aldridge. Coach was motivating his team, saying, quote, guys, we can do this. We've got to make it harder on him out there. Nothing easy. We've got to try to cool this guy off. Those are likely not the last adjustments they make today, guys. There's still time left in this one. Back to you, Kevin.
And thanks for that story, Doris. And there's the foul. It goes on Wesley Matthews. That's foul number two for him. 1:10 left in the third quarter. Feeds it to Prince. Williams with the steal.
Now the defender was so close to him on that pump fake that he just took the ball out of his hands.
Obviously, they're evenly matched teams on the inside. The rebound numbers are very even.
Yeah, I've been impressed with just both teams' energy, just really working hard on the board.
There's 48 seconds left in the third. Batum inside the three-point line. Trailblazers keep it alive. Pass to Williams. Back to Batum. Outside Matthews. Shot clock at six. Plenty of room to knock down the shot. And the Trailblazers lead by five. Memphis has gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. Outside Conley. Step back on that one and let it fly.
This has been a different kind of game here in the second half. I thought both clubs a little slow in the first.
No question, but they're really going at it now.
Williams. And misses it off the right side of the rim. Gets it off. No good trying to beat the buzzer. Three quarters of play in a close game here. Trailblazers.
Tune in Tuesday, December 3rd.
And let's take this opportunity now to show you our State Farm assist of the game.
Well, we might as well call it the State Farm play of the game. This was just a marvelous piece of coordination between two teammates, completely in sync on the alley-oop.
The Grizzlies trail by three. Zebo and Marc Gasol are up front. Allen and Prince on the perimeter. And it's Conley in at the point guard position. That's the lineup in the game for Memphis. Now here's Prince. Steps back and fires. Connects. The jumper drops. Prince has got the first points up on the board here in the fourth for the Grizzlies. And the Trailblazers shooting has been fun to watch in this game. They're at 57%. And Matthews kicks to Lillard. Back to Matthews, and it's out of bounds to Portland. They'll retain possession. Here's what Memphis has lined up on their schedule. Next matchup, they'll be home against the Suns. Here's Lillard. Unloads, and Matthews gets it to go in on the assist by Lillard. Lillard's got his fifth assist in this one. Conley dishes to Prince. The 15-footer. Here's Randolph. No good. Good D by Lopez.
He was right there, but the defensive pressure forced that miss.
Well contested. That really made it a tough shot.
Lillard misses. The Grizzlies trail by three. Prince kicks to Conley. Right side, Conley. True on the 14-footer.
Boy, bad timing. Now is not the time to be giving him that shot.
First minute and a half of basketball played here in the fourth quarter. And Lillard kicks to Batum. To the right side. Poked away. Pass to Lillard. He feeds it to Aldridge. And it hung on the rim, but wouldn't fall for him. Prince against Matthews. Allen kicks to Conley. To take the lead, and it's good.
And his confidence has come back since halftime after really a rough first two quarters.
For Portland, they've gone 1 of 3 from the field to start the fourth quarter. Time called here. The Blazers decide to talk it over.
Yeah, he definitely saw some things that were not working for them out there. And now he's going to make some adjustments.
I'm not sure what it was, but he clearly wanted something to change out there.
Let's find out what Doris Burke has for us.
Hey, Kevin, during that last break, I heard Terry Stotts as he addressed his team. He told them to stick with what's worked to this point, saying, listen, they're giving us all the space we need inside. Let's take advantage of it. Keep working the ball inside the paint.
And so here's Portland. Aldridge with it. Guarded now by Randolph. Lillard attacking. That's good.
A large part of what they've been able to do here is centered around his offense.
And let's quickly check out the scoring breakdown here for the Trailblazers.
They've been the aggressors, and they've been tougher in the paint all game.
I like the work they've been doing in the low post, too. I mean, we've seen a lot of points coming on the inside all day.
Now here is Conley. Allen, right side. Kicks to Gasol. Lays it up and banks it in.
This has been a terrific contest up to this point, and I would guess it's going to stay this way all the way to the end. Great matchup.
Probably so. Neither team wants to give an inch.
Lillard against Conley. Now, here's Lillard. He's covered closely. Here's Aldridge. Somehow ignores the tight D and gets the layup.
And at this stage of the game, that offensive rebound and putback is enormous. I mean, that feels like a four-point swing.
Conley, the pass to Allen. Looking for Conley. He gets it there. And another basket for Memphis.
It hasn't happened as quickly as he would have liked, but he's finally putting some points on the board in this game.
Time called here. The Blazers decide to talk it over. The score knotted at 48. There's a minute 47 left in the fourth. A moment to check in with Doris Burke. Doris?
Well, over the break, I listened in on what Terry Stotts had to say in his huddle. The focus of the discussion was getting their offense to run through Aldridge. Coach obviously has a ton of faith in his offensive ability and shared that faith with the rest of the players by insisting they get him more involved. Also, he wants them building a wall around the rim defensively and forcing shots to come from the perimeter, not in the paint. So, Coach, waiting until the final stages to pull a few tricks out of his sleeve. Kevin, let's see if he's made a wise decision.
Great. Thanks for the report, Doris. Aldridge left side. That's good. And the Trailblazers lead by 2.
Unstoppable offense from both teams. I love the pace this game has been played at.
So does everybody else in the building. This has been a fun one.
Gasol's shot is good.
And that's another assist for a team that is putting on a clinic on how to share the ball.
I just love the mentality they've had. If a shot isn't there, they're not forcing anything. They're moving it side to side and working to get a good shot.
Now, here's Lillard. Here's Batum. And that one goes long. The Grizzlies have gone 6 of 8 from the field in the fourth so far. It's been a great start to this final quarter for them.
And that is the shot of the game.
Well, he's got the guts and courage to take it and the skill to make it.
Trailblazers have gotten just under 45% of their attempts to drop in the fourth, 4 of 9. Lillard dishes to Matthews. Tie game. That is a huge basket right there. That one just took the air right out of the crowd.
Yeah, he simply said, sit down and keep quiet with that one.
Yep, that's right. Nothing coming out of these fans now.
You got to put bodies on the glass right there. They just are not getting it done on the board.
Yeah, they've got to do a much better job of going harder than that to the glass.
Now, here's Matthews. Shot clock and game clock separated by less than 6 seconds. It's good. This game is all even.
Guys, he's one of the main reasons this game is tied up. I mean, he's done his part to keep them in it.
Lillard against Conley. Allen outside. It's Prince on the wing. No good from three-point territory. Now a timeout called by Portland. Here's Lopez. Here's Aldridge. Oh, off target.
Well, they had a foul to give, but they couldn't get it done before that shot attempt.
Yeah, and giving up free throws isn't ideal here, Steve. You know that, but at least they've got the clock stopped.
Second one is good. Getting both at the line. It's a two-point ball game.
Cold-blooded trip to the line there. They're just one stop away from winning this thing now.
Now a timeout called by Memphis. Guys, your thoughts?
Your only chance here is to lob it towards the basket and go for the tip-in. There's not enough time left to catch and shoot.
Conley inside the line. Oh, he had a chance there to send it to overtime, but they come up empty-handed. And so the big win by Portland in a tight